Hello, everybody. It's me and Josh Johnson. And me is Dulcé Sloan. I'm not good at doing these intros, but I feel like Josh has been doing a lot of heavy lifting. And I'm feeling like a crumb bum over here, just letting Josh do all the work.
A crumb bum? A crumb bum.
Yeah, it's like we're co-hosting, but I'm like, if we're co-hosting, like, I gotta do some of the work too.
Never heard that before. I've never heard crumb bum.
Oh yeah, crumb bum. I think our crumb bum is almost like a yum yum, where it's like somebody, like, you ever know somebody that's just always like, they have the means, but they're always like just asking you for food.
Yeah.
It's not like the girlfriend saying, oh, I'm not hungry. It's not the same thing. This person is eating.
Yeah. They're eating well.
Right. But it's like, it's like, you know, do you want your cornbread? It's kind of like
a crumb bum.
A crumb bum.
We're so excited to bring this episode to you, the public, because it's one of contention. It's probably going to be the one that gets listeners the most fired up out of the ones that we've talked about. Because
other than ketchup being tomato soup.
Hey, let the past be the past.
Have you looked at the YouTube comments?
I will never look at those YouTube comments.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you what one of the first things you learn as a comic is never look at the YouTube comics. If you're someone who's on TV,
yeah,
never look at the YouTube comments. And I can tell you the ones that I've looked at, I don't know if there's a filter that goes through, because usually if you're a woman that looks like me on the internet, someone's calling you fat. Someone's taking the time from their American heathen day to type into Al Gore's internet that I have more than one chin. And one, they're not doing that unless someone from our team is just going through and being like, nope. Or YouTube finally cares about people, but I don't think that's happening. And wow, people are not feeling, because somebody was like, yo, Josh, I get it. You were trying to win, bro, but tomato soup being ketchup, I think you've gone too far, baby. I think you've really affected hearts and minds, Joshua.
I mean, all right, never mind. All the other episodes, it's like we're kind of deep now. Like, there's so many other episodes where I make salient points, and then this is the one that really sticks with
people. People have mentioned
people.
That. They're like, man, Josh has made so many other great points. What happened?
Okay.
Yeah, it was interesting because they're like, yo, dude, I know you were trying to win, but you were too far. You were too far to the other direction. You went too far to the left, bro. Left, right, up, down. You did too much. And so,
I mean, this is the one that I will really affect people.
Well, I think it's interesting because the topic for today is chocolate versus vanilla.
Mm-hmm.
And first of all, I just want to take a second. If you were watching this on YouTube, stop the video after I ask this question. Who do you think is going to go for what? Do you think Josh is going to pick vanilla, or do you think I'm going to pick vanilla? Do you think Josh is going to pick chocolate, or I'm going to pick chocolate? Who do you think is going to pick what? I'm going to give you a second. So, just to let you know, this is chocolate versus vanilla. And guess what, y'all? Your girl, okay? Spicy Calderon. Your girl's team vanilla. Ha, you didn't see that coming, did you? Did you? You didn't think? That me, old what's-her-face, was going to be picking vanilla. But I did. Isn't that wild? What a twist.
So help us out. Help us by explaining why vanilla for you.
I think vanilla for me, one, it is an ice cream flavor that I grew up with because my mom likes to add things to ice cream. So we would get the pecan sandies. Mm-hmm. We'll put those in ice cream. Sometimes just as simple as, you know, throwing in your favorite cereal. Maybe putting your own little fruits. You know, vanilla was a carrier for flavors, right? Some of my favorite ice cream flavors, like Moose Tracks, the base is vanilla. Like those flavored ice creams, like I never really got into Ben and Jerry's, mainly because it was expensive. But if you give me a Blue Bell situation, you give me a Mayfield situation, a Mayfield Moose Tracks, a Mayfield Turtle Tracks, okay? If there's tracks, I'm eating them. if an animal is out here putting his imprint on the planet with caramel or chocolatates, put it in my face, okay? I like vanilla. Basically, when I think of vanilla, I think of ice cream. And there's different types of vanillas. There's different kind of carrier flavors. One thing I used to really love to do is when we go to the Chinese buffet, because you grew up in the South, there were always Chinese buffets. At the end of the meal, you go and get your little soft serve ice cream. And then I would add a little lemon juice, like a little fresh squeezed lemon. That was a nice palate cleanser after eating all the variety of things you eat at a Chinese buffet. I do honestly prefer it over, like, in cakes. I don't prefer, like, I've never had a chocolate birthday cake because I've never wanted a chocolate birthday cake. I've made chocolate birthday cakes. I've made chocolate cakes for people.
I guess this is my thing. This is where I feel like you are so misguided.
Wow, what the hell? Good night.
This is where... So I look at vanilla as one, right? As like the, if we are talking flavors, vanilla is the number one as far as units of flavor and taste. Okay. It's where you start. It's a good place to start.
You're telling me a scale from 1 to 10.
From 1 to 10. And okay. I'll even say this. People give vanilla a 0. It's a 1 because it is a flavor. It's not plain. It's vanilla. Right.
Right.
But you can't really enhance it. Like you said, it's a character.
It's a carrier.
Oh, okay. It's a carrier. So then it's a platform for other flavors. It's not a real flavor that's out here striking joy into hearts and minds. It's just out here helping cherries and sprinkles get along.
But it's also, did you think about it as a collaborator, a peacekeeper? A helping hand to bring different flavors together.
How about this? I've enjoyed a triple chocolate cake. You can't have a triple vanilla anything because vanilla is vanilla. It's one. And you can't multiply one times one.
You could have a vanilla. Well, I mean, it's not triple, but you can like have a vanilla cake with vanilla frosting. That's a thing that exists.
It's a thing that exists that all tastes the same. It's just a steady attack on your taste buds where you're getting overwhelmed with the vanilla.
Listen, I presented my case, okay? Now you present your case.
Okay.
Your very predictable case. Of being team chocolate.
My very predictable. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Chocolate came to us, blessed us, was discovered in multiple countries. All right. It came to us from multiple parts of the earth.
No.
You know, the
came
cacao.
From the New World.
What?
New World.
What are you talking about, New World?
Sir.
It's all been one world the entire time.
Ma'am. Have
it's all been of... one Ma'am. Planet. I'm Man. Not, no. Don't pull from that colonial history. The whole world's been the whole world the entire time.
The whole world has been the whole world the entire time, yes. In God's eyes, he built one planet. I get it. It's these white folks with books that made it new and old.
Mm-hmm.
So they ain't known about chocolate. Are we trying to say they're known about chocolate? You're trying to say that chocolate was not in the it's in the conquered countries, conquered continent.
Mm-hmm. I mean, all I'm saying is what they called the New World was really the old world because they just hadn't discovered it yet. But it had been around.
I hear you. That's why we call Native American Indians because somebody didn't know where the fuck that was at. I hear you.
Yeah. Yeah.
I got you.
Mm-hmm. I'm just saying that chocolate doesn't come from one specific area or country in all of the world. Lots of countries bring us chocolate and they bring us their spins on chocolate.
Sidebar.
And they bring us, yeah.
Have you seen that Ghana has told these white folks that you are no longer going to take a raw bean out of here and then process it on your own. We're going to process this shit and you're going to have to pay us.
Ghana is not playing
with these hoes. Ghana, the president of Ghana, he is not playing with these white folks no more. You understand? He's like, y'all not going to be coming up in our country and taking shit. If you want this cacao, you have to come to us. You ain't getting raw beans. We're going to process it and then give you that shit. Because you've been in here getting you've been getting uncut, the raw, okay? And don't want us to have no processing plants. Oh, boy, said, fuck y'all. Keep praying for them. I'm worried about his safety. Because these white folks are a problem.
So all I'm saying is chocolate comes to us at different degrees as well. So you can see the percentages. They tell us the percentages now of cacao in the chocolate.
Absolutely. And that just lets you know how stepped on it is.
I understand. But that pure, right? So those bittersweets, those 75%, those 25% and those Hershey's, they all have different flavors. They're all coming from a different place. Vanilla, it can't get stepped on because it comes out stepped on.
Have you ever seen a vanilla bean?
Yeah, I've seen a vanilla bean.
But that's an old world plant. So you have to remember, like, at one point, you know, we think of it as very generic because we have all the things here.
Yeah, because like, it is.
But at one time, sugar was exotic.
Mm-hmm.
Because motherfuckers didn't have sugar.
I mean, if we have to go in the past for vanilla to have a leg up,
sir,
then like,
we just went to the past about chocolate. We just went to the past about chocolate. I'm not saying at one point all of these things were exotic. Italy didn't have noodles until Marco Polo came back from China. If it was not for the Chinese, the Italians, what would they be making? What are they cooking? What are they famous for?
Give real good meatballs.
And
like, as far as meatballs, fire.
Sidebar, check this out. Tomatoes, new world plant. Noodles came from China. If it was not for somebody leaving Italy, what would they eat, bro?
Real good meatballs.
All olive oil, everything. So yeah, I'm just saying, fire meatballs. Fire this bread though.
So I'm just throwing it out there. Yeah, I'm just throwing it out there that there are different degrees or different levels of chocolate. If we're just even going to keep it to bars, right? Bars, these bars, a vanilla bar is fine.
Why are you saying that so hard?
And a chocolate bar, that's how we want them. That's how we take them. That's how we love them.
Okay.
Chocolate bar. And how many types of chocolate bars are there? The most you're going to get out of vanilla bars is cookies and cream, which is still getting a little chocolate in it to help it along because it's struggling.
Vanilla is a bean. So you can't turn vanilla into a bar because it doesn't even have, it's like, if you think of all the things we do with like different beans, like soybeans and stuff like that,
mm-hmm.
vanilla is like, it's dried and you're just taking the seeds out and it's very much like an extraction process, but there's no, like, I did not know probably until I was almost in college that cocoa butter comes from chocolate plant. Mm-hmm. I didn't know where cocoa butter came from.
Okay.
So like you ever had like white chocolate?
Mm-hmm.
White chocolate is basically a stick of cocoa butter from what I've heard.
I mean, that I don't know enough to correct you, but the fact that you don't get any dark vanilla, but you can get white chocolate, just another way that chocolate is being more versatile in these streets. It's just another way that chocolate is coming at you in different colors and different flavors. I just think chocolate can go places vanilla can't.
That's an apple and orange situation. We're talking about flavors, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think for me, I don't like white chocolate. I like milk chocolate, but I have found out that by going over, you know, going to Canada, going to Europe, going to Mexico, the rest of the world hates our chocolate. Apparently it's disgusting.
No, we're not doing well.
Did not know that our chocolate was trash. I did not know.
I've known for a long time that.
I can say that, yeah. I've never been a huge fan of our chocolate, like a Hershey bar. No. I don't want that. I don't want to eat a whole bar. First of all, a bar of chocolate always seemed like way too much.
But that's why they have the little divots for you to break it off, for you to have as much as you want to have while you're having it.
Because they know the whole thing is just ridiculous.
Like, the whole thing is too much. Yeah.
Right.
The whole thing. Like, you break it per serving size. And so a Hershey bar, break four of those little things. Have that. Save that.
Two is my max, and then eventually I'll wrap it up and set it somewhere and go, either it's in the fridge for the rest of my life White chocolate isn't even really chocolate. It's chocolate that they've taken the cocoa out of. Mm-hmm. So there's no cocoa. It's just fat.
Mm-hmm.
And then they've injected chocolate flavor into so it.
I see. That. No. I see the point that you're trying to make. But what I still see is vanilla struggling so hard that chocolate had to vanilla do a plasma donation.
Wow. Or maybe
on behalf of the white colored candies.
Or maybe vanilla doesn't have to go with Sammy Sosa. Okay. Doesn't have to be the last iteration of Michael Jackson to be out here doing his job. Okay. I don't want to bring Michael into this. Sammy Sosa, we all know, looks like a thumb. Doesn't make any sense.
Don't act like I'm making you do these things. I didn't want to have to. Like, you're pulling out all the stops now. Because
of something. Vanilla knows who vanilla is. And vanilla's like, listen, I'm flavoring things, okay? I'm giving you, because look at this, the nature of the flavors, okay? Chocolate is heavy, okay? It's going to sit on the tongue. But there's a fat content. There's oils behind it. There's a lot of things that chocolate is doing because there are different aspects to it, right? Like, for vanilla, on the other hand, hey, baby, I'm a bean and you put me in shit, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I'm doing cakes. I'm doing creams, all right? I'm giving you, it's a whole different campaign. There's way less processing when you're dealing with vanilla. No, there's no vanilla bars. Because if you try to make a vanilla bar, it'd be like a white chocolate situation where you need some type of base and then you're injecting flavor. But that's not how vanilla works. Vanilla is giving you a lightness, okay? Chocolate came in to be heavy. Chocolate came in to step on your feet and be like, hey, what's going on? What you doing? About to fuck up your teeth, okay? No kids going to the dentist or the dentist, okay? Ain't nobody sitting up getting caught with vanilla all on their face. It's not happening. They have better, vanilla has better press because vanilla is a more refined situation. Vanilla's not out here in your whole Halloween. That's what vanilla's doing. Vanilla's a classy bitch. All right, vanilla sitting down is like, hey. Yeah, vanilla can't be in everything, okay? You got triple chocolate cakes. You got chocolate on chocolate on chocolate on chocolate. Vanilla comes in, boom. That's the flavor. There's vanilla and then there's a little vanilla bean. Chocolate, on the other hand, is letting you know it is stepped on like a motherfucker. Chocolate is letting you know, hey, I can be bitter, I can be sweet, I can be stepped on. All it is stepped on, okay? We know American chocolate. Okay, sidebar. Also, we have to mention this one thing. Have you ever had a chocolate orange?
Yeah.
What do you think about it?
That was fine.
I think that's a flavor you have to grow up with.
No, I can see that. Because the people who love it have always been eating it. That's very fair.
And they're not American at all.
They also love to crack it, to like open it. It's like an event. Like, that's how you can tell that they grew up with it, because they love to press down, which opens up all the slices, and then they eat it.
I mean, as things go. But I was annoyed, one, when you bite into it, that it's hollow.
Yeah.
Because there's nothing. I'm like, I thought there was going to be an orange cream situation. I thought this might have been a Cadbury situation. I thought they were going to give me more, right?
Okay.
It's an orange, a chocolate orange. I thought that it was going to be more than just the shape of a fucking orange. But it's kind of cool that it's in slices. You can distribute it to your friends or to your children, right? It's cool. It's whatever. I'm just saying, I've had a whole type of chocolate. Listen, what you're not going to do, because I know what you're closing. I've met you. I know what you're closing argument.
What I'm not going to do, just for the record. This is unedited. I was being quiet. I was listening. No. Out of nowhere, I get a wheels. What you're not going to do.
I know the wheels, nigga. I know the wheels. And the wheels on this bus were eventually going to get us to the chocolate room at Harrods. That's where these wheels were going to go.
Because you were gonna even thinking about it.
What? Then you don't know how to do this right.
No. I wasn't even thinking about it. I'll tell you why. Because why? I was going to let you punch yourself out. Because in my mind, yes, there are some situations where we're talking apples to oranges. But it's apples to oranges because chocolate can go so many places that vanilla can't. All right? You talking not about not all go? Up in people's Halloween? Let's talk about the fact that really a lot of people don't even want vanilla like that. So vanilla can call itself classy. It can call itself sophisticated. It can call itself particular and choosy. But nobody is choosing vanilla. When was the last time you saw a vanilla fountain at a party? Help me.
You can't, because vanilla Help doesn't me. Come... Because vanilla doesn't come in a liquid form like that, okay? That's not how
it sounds like it's not versatile. It sounds...
It's not versatile. It's not the best you've heard in a while. What I'm saying is that... Thank you for getting that reference. That versatile, don't just shake it's record with style. What I'm saying is that because of what vanilla is...
Mm.
Also, you know that chocolate in them damn chocolate fountains... is never high quality. It's never great. It's never good. Come on. Don't be using chocolate fountains. Nigga, they got nacho cheese fountains too, okay? I don't know if you ever saw, have you seen this clip from TLC where this woman talking about her wedding and she wanted a ranch fountain? She wanted a ranch fountain, Josh. Honestly, I want to see it. I want to see a ranch fountain, okay? I'm sure they have a marinara sauce fountain. We out here putting anything liquid in a fountain.
I honestly think a marinara sauce fountain can't happen because it would be far too splashy. Like, you can't even approach that thing without messing up your whole shirt.
It is splashy. You need something that's kind of... You need... That makes me think that a ranch fountain would be splashy, too.
It might be, yeah.
Because you need something that'll come down in a ribbon. You need something that'll hold its shape.
Something beautiful and smooth like chocolate. I'm with you. I understand.
Yeah, nacho cheese. Something that, and when it's room temperature, is solid. That's what I'm talking about.
You know that this is tantamount to terrorism, all right? Because
terrorism is ketchup is tomato soup. Salsa and tomato soup.
Honestly.
Carl Bin Laden. You are his predecessor. You are his greatest student. When you sat up and looked me in my Christian face and told me that salsa was tomato soup, you fucking savage.
Look. All I'm saying, all I am getting at, all I am approaching you with.
Okay.
Is the fact the
adulterated?
No.
Mitigated?
No. The unquestionable fact.
Not questionable, bro.
That chocolate is going places and doing things that vanilla is too limited to do.
I think about this. You know how we're all into all these nut milks?
Some of us are, yeah. Some of us know what a lie is.
True. It's juice. Yeah.
Yeah.
I want us to stop doing this. You had to blend up these cashews and squeeze them.
Juice. Yeah.
Also, why is there no peanut milk? Why we pick these very specific nuts?
Yeah. We need some peanut juice out here.
And it's peanut juice. Is there pistachio milk? You know what I want to... Like,
I think
many?
So.
Is it? That sounds expensive.
It sounds very expensive because if you've even held eight pistachios, you've held $6.
So there's never going to be macadamia milk because that's going to be $150 a gallon.
That honestly, macadamia milk is what I feel like rich kids get with their babies.
That's like, so funny.
Just a buttery milk.
All I'm saying is that because there is no, yes, chocolate can do different things than vanilla can do because of just the nature of the plant, right? Like an orange tree can do more than an oak tree. Mm. Oak tree just standing there, putting shade in your yard.
Yeah, yeah.
Orange trees give you fruits. Mm-hmm. Oh, somebody was like, I found out that some cities, you know how people have like tried to say that like the trees that are in cities should be like food bearing trees for like people in the population who are having like, you know, food issues, like food scarcity or whatever, or people who are unhoused. There are a lot of cities that don't allow you to have fruit bearing trees in the city because for that reason, they're like, no, we don't want people be able to.
No, it's wild.
That's wild. Like every tree, like I get, if you're in fucking Oklahoma or like Colorado trying to grow an orange tree, that makes no sense. But just have it like appropriate to where your climate is. People are evil. Anyway, for the same way that oak tree can't do what an orange tree does, because of the nature of said plants, vanilla is not going to do what chocolate does and vice versa. You see what I'm saying?
I do see what you're saying.
The reason I've never been a huge chocolate fan is because, first of all, like first time I had like European chocolate, I was like, oh, this is so much better. Because it's not what we have. Also, whoever put chocolate and peanut butter together, God bless. God bless that human being. Because that is fucking delicious.
I wonder what happens when you put vanilla and peanut butter together. Do you just throw up immediately, or do you like? I don't know.
Those are two competitive. Some stuff don't work together. Chocolate and vanilla don't work. Like, listen, you ever as a kid got Neapolitan ice cream? My question is, which flavor was always left in the container when you got Neapolitan ice cream? What was the last one? Was it strawberry? Because my house was always strawberry.
I feel like it varied based on
who was in the house.
Yeah. I feel like after the divorce.
Interesting.
Yeah, I feel like my dad ate the chocolate the fastest.
Okay.
And then when it was just my mom and I, the whole distribution was just different. Like you would just see, it looked like, you know, like when you're playing music and you got a little icon with the levels in it.
Yeah.
The race to the bottom just looked like that movement. So I'm trying to think of what was like last.
I think for us, it was always the strawberry. But I can say my mom, and I loved it, would buy, you remember those huge tubs with the handle on them of the vanilla ice cream?
Yeah, I think so.
It was a plastic tub with a red handle on it. My mom would buy that when I was a kid. And so, because I remember as a kid not liking how chocolate ice cream tasted because it had a weird ass aftertaste. And even as an adult, having tried very expensive chocolate ice cream and, you know, gelatos and shit, and being in like nice ass places, traveling the world, I still get that weird ass aftertaste from a chocolate ice cream. I think sometimes chocolate cake. I think I like a lighter. Now, I love a brownie. Brownies are my jam because brownies for me seem to be the right balance of chocolate to other things. But like chocolate cakes, I'm not always like a chocolate cake. That's too much. I need something else to like break this shit up.
Can I offer up one extra thing?
Try it.
I don't think that when you go to other countries, you get the good vanilla. I think that what's happening is the pinnacle of vanilla we've already tasted and it's fine. And then you go to another country and you have their chocolate.
What do you think the pinnacle of vanilla is?
I think the absolute best vanilla I've ever had was something that really brought out the flavor of the bean. And it did complement the other flavors that were with it. Because what are your favorite, just as an example, what's your favorite type of vanilla pie?
We mean vanilla pie.
Like, do you count cheesecake as like a cake? Do you count it as a pie? Do you count? I'm trying to think of times we put pies with lots of vanilla flavor.
Why don't we put vanilla flavoring in cheesecake?
Because you know how you can have a chocolate pie.
Yeah, like you can have a chocolate pie. You have a chocolate pecan pie. You can have a chocolate pudding pie.
Yeah.
Banana pudding is a very famous vanilla flavored situation. There's bananas in it.
There's bananas in it. And sometimes those bananas completely overpower the vanilla.
Oh, I am the person that always picks the bananas out because I don't like bananas. I love plantains.
That's for another day. You heard it here right now at minute whatever of this episode.
Yeah.
Plantains versus bananas is gonna happen.
Oh, you know what? Our next episode, plantains versus bananas. We're doing it.
Please.
You ready?
Please don't.
You ready?
You set yourself up. You set yourself up.
Come on.
Okay.
Come on. Come with it.
I don't think you're really ready to lose back to back.
You're not ready to lose back to back. Your greatest failure was salsa is tomato soup.
Mm-hmm. Episodes ago. You're still clinging on to that old
ass. Ma'am, that was not episodes ago. Okay? Don't do that, ma'am. Don't do that.
When you even have a topping, there's not that many vanilla toppings that go on to chocolate ice cream. But there's lots of chocolate toppings that pop, 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 pop all over that vanilla scoop. Okay?
So you're saying that there's no vanilla toppings?
Just not many.
What if chocolate is just loose? What if chocolate is just for the streets?
What if chocolate's doing too much? You are not gonna call my delicious mocha, my delicious dark, my delicious milk. You're not gonna call all of my chocolates hoes. That's not what's gonna happen.
I'm just saying that it had to be so versatile because it could not focus. It had.
We need to sit down and pray for your loose, your plain, your basic vanilla. That's what we need to do.
What if chocolate is doing all of this because it couldn't? There's no refinement. Okay, maybe it's McDonald's. Okay. Maybe it's McDonald's. Maybe it's out here just throwing anything.
No, you need to slow. You need to slow where you're going right now
because
you're about
nothing.
To crash. All right,
I ain't gotta do
you about to crash. You
nothing.
Sound as someone who was the tomato soup. You sound like the tomato soup right now.
Don't you?
Because
don't,
when you say,
but I know chocolate is still chocolate. I know chocolate is still chocolate. I'm not finna sit up and say that. Listen, salsa will never be tomato soup. Okay.
When
chocolate
you sit
will
there,
always be doing all of this out here, okay?
When you say that, what if chocolate is McDonald's? Please remember.
What?
What flavor of McFlurry is and is vanilla. Only vanilla.
And then you just add stuff. It's like a blizzard at Dairy Queen. It's a base. It's giving what it can do is it can give you other things. Or it could just be an ice cream cup. One of the first times as a child that you was able to use a machine, from the first time you saw an ice cream cone coming out of a machine, it was vanilla or vanilla chocolate swirl. But it was vanilla day one, baby. Vanilla been here since you had teeth.
That's simply not true. It was vanilla or chocolate or the swirl.
Hey, oh, you out here? So your machine had three nozzles. Congratulations. Look at God.
And look, I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to get me to go off the rails, and it's not going to work.
No. Listen, you got to go off the rails.
Because the rails
are fine and established. All I'm saying is you are really coming at me like you own Hershey's, like you own Lindor, like you own all of it. Don't mean nothing to me. Okay?
No, name me one of the vanilla companies. Go ahead.
What you mean?
What do you mean? What do I mean? You just started rattling it off. Chocolate companies. Tell me those great, beautiful, powerful empires of vanilla.
What?
They don't exist.
Madagascar, baby.
The country?
It's their. You said empires. That is their. McCormick, okay? That's who's out here giving you vanilla. But this is the thing. I named chocolate companies. You've never had. You can buy vanilla beans, right?
Mm-hmm.
And do whatever you need in your life, okay?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You can't go pick up a bag of cacao beans. That's not happening. You got to process this. You just can't show up. and be like, hey, let me get that pod. Let me get that giant bean and get the seeds out. Dry these seeds, ground them, add sugar. Because what you have to remember is that you've never had chocolate in its pure form. Chocolate is not sweet.
It's not about being sweet.
It's about
being delicious. It's about being versatile.
And all they do is add sugar to it. When they do something with a vanilla bean, you infuse it with a cream. You know, you can have that vanilla flavor. You ever had Baker's chocolate?
The bittersweet?
No. Baker's chocolate.
Just the big brick of chocolate.
Yeah, but the thing is, Baker's chocolate is actually the true form of chocolate because there's no sugar in it. I remember the episode of Roseanne where DJ bit into Baker's chocolate. He's like, ugh. I tried to tell you 6 times. So what I'm saying is chocolate in its raw form.
Mm-hmm.
It's not good if you put sugar in it.
That's simply not true.
Have you had plain chocolate?
I have had plain chocolate. And no, I've also had the darkest of dark chocolate from.
They still put sugar in it.
No, I know, but that one, when you go to like Ecuador, or you go to these countries that do the 95%.
Oh, so for you to prove this point, you had to go to Ecuador?
I didn't have to go to Ecuador. I'm simply saying that at every level of putting sugar in chocolate, all the way to no sugar, it was fire. All the way to no sugar. So from no sugar all the way to just sugar, chocolate is dope. And it's useful. It's useful.
If it was dope. How come nobody's, if it was dope, chocolate with no sugar? Why is that not something you can really, like, other than like big ass brick or Baker's chocolate, which also looks stepped on. No one, because dark chocolate, because like they've given us dark chocolate, given us milk chocolate, given all those things, right?
Mm-hmm.
So dark chocolate is chocolate that has no milk in it. Is that what dark chocolate is?
Like, no, dark chocolate has less sugar, almost no ingredients. Like when you see the percentages of like the cacao in it, that's mm-hmm. when you know it's like truly not only just quality, but also healthier for you because there's almost no ingredients at all. So the only ingredient will be what they put in it with the mix. So if you have like a matcha dark chocolate, you'll read it and it'll say like the bittersweet chocolate, the matcha green. And cane sugar will usually be like one of the last ingredients, which means they put the least of there.
They let these people put grass in this chocolate?
You can put anything in chocolate.
What about matcha?
Yeah.
Tastes like grass.
I've had it, and they made it very good.
It's grass. It's very complicated to make, but it tastes like fresh lawn.
Because your vanilla is like a platform. You said it yourself. It's a carrier.
No one's making money off of it, okay? I'm not making no money off of this vanilla. You're not making no money off of this vanilla. So you're making no money off this chocolate. Hey, okay?
Then vanilla in general is like a carrier. It sits. It's a platform. It's like an elevator floor. All right.
But it can also.
Chocolate is the whole house.
No.
It's
but
the whole house you're in.
But vanilla can be. Listen, when you look at these specialty flavor ice creams.
Mm-hmm.
Chocolate is not always the base. Because if you put a bunch of stuff in a chocolate ice cream, it just tastes like chocolate ice cream. Right? But vanilla, throw a little caramel swirl in it. Throw a little fudge swirl. Hey, do both. You're an American. Nobody can stop you. You're awful. So out here throwing all kinds of things in this ice cream, right? Because it's a collaborator, okay? Chocolate is a bully. It's pushing all other flavors out the way. Like,
this is insane. This is wild. Hey, I'm telling you, as someone who's been where you are right now, this is a mirror, okay? I'm trying to help you the way you tried to help me. Chocolate is a bully.
Okay, sitting up melting in your hands, getting all over your face, making you look like that you ain't a college graduate. All right.
Why are there so many chocolate candies and there aren't that many vanilla candies? We've already established that bars.
Because of the nature of the plant. For the same reason that there's orange juice and not pine juice. There's no flower, like there's no, You get juice out of fruit. We're not asking plants that don't have fruit to be juice.
So wait, what was that apple juice versus pine juice thing?
You're saying that there's no vanilla bars, and there's no vanilla bars because of the nature of vanilla.
And now I'm asking why there's no vanilla loose. There's no vanilla M&Ms. There's no vanilla. You know what I'm saying? Like loose candies.
Because it is a flavor that comes from. Think of it like more like a herb, because it's a plant that gives you a flavor. So like your bay leaves, oreganos, stuff like that. So you're not going to get the same things out of vanilla that you get out of chocolate because of the nature of the plant. You can't get, like, you can't squeeze vanilla and get oil. Like, you can't get oil out of every, like, you can get soybean oil, you know, canola. I still don't know what a canola is, but.
Yeah, I've never met a canola.
I've never seen her in the streets. I've never seen her out here working. She does what she does, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But also sesame oil. What a tiny seed. What a tiny seed.
Giving us flavor.
Giving us flavor, bro.
Like I remember the first time I had something with sesame oil in it. I was like, I think that must have been the devil. Because that was just too much flavor hitting me all at once. That was insane.
And you've ever eaten a sesame seed? It didn't give you all of that.
No. I've had an everything bagel and it tastes like nothing.
Nothing. So the fact that, like, they're really out here, they were like, listen, we got these tiny ass seeds. We're going to squeeze on this plant. We're going to do something out here, right?
What I will offer up, though, is to your point of think of it as an herb. There are herbs that can be candied that we have mints. A mint is an herb, right? Isn't a mint an herb?
There's vanilla candy. We know there's vanilla candy.
I know there's vanilla candy. I'm asking you to offer up what vanilla candies stack up to all the chocolate candies that are out there. I'm not saying why aren't there any. I'm saying what do you think is a good vanilla candy?
Honestly, my favorite candy is Reese's Pieces.
Ooh.
Just a little,
ooh, why would you tell me? Why would you offer it up on camera?
It used to be Butterfingers. It was Snickers, Butterfingers.
Ooh.
And then,
oh, you're killing me right now.
And then I just got to the source where it was just like, I just want peanut butter. That's all I want. So now my favorite candy is Reese's Pieces.
I will throw it out there one more time because I feel like I didn't quite get my question answered from before.
Well, what?
You know, we both agree that we had chocolate in all of its forms here. And it wasn't until we either traveled abroad or had the chocolate from abroad that we were like, wow, this is it, right?
Yeah.
I'm asking why you think that the vanilla that we have isn't better in other places. I'll offer it up, extend the olive branch. I've never had Madagascar vanilla, but I also haven't had any vanilla that was better than the vanilla I grew up with. And that's where the refinement is bumping me, because you talk about refined sophistication, can't be everywhere, can't be doing everything. But then when it's doing any other thing, it tastes just like it did when it was doing the other stuff.
Wow. So did you ever have the vanilla Tootsie Roll?
I did.
When Tootsie Roll came out with flavors, now I can say Tootsie Roll don't do chocolate that great. So I was not impressed, but I can tell you it was the strawberry one that they did.
The strawberry, the orange is pretty good.
Banging. I think Tootsie Roll has really just missed the mark. Like, fuck it. Just roll
it. It should have been flavors the whole time.
Should have been flavors the whole time.
I would agree with that. I have no problem offering up that not every chocolate company is doing chocolate to the degree that it deserves.
Right.
You know? But I just don't know what vanilla is doing. I feel like vanilla is the flavor of the 1700s. You know, it's just, it's time has passed.
I don't think it's time has passed. I think it's still giving us, because there's like, you know, we've got vanilla fudge. We got other vanilla candies, you know, those little cream savers. That's vanilla.
Vanilla fudge.
I was surprised about it. Also, I realized vanilla is like, fudge is too much for me sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
So I can always get down with fudge.
Now, is every fudge chocolate?
No, you can have like the toffee fudge.
Remember, you can toffee fudge. Yeah,
you have different flavors of fudge. I thought fudge had to be chocolate. Until I went to college with a lot of white women, and they were like, "Oh no, girl, you can make fudge anything." Because there's peanut butter fudge. You've had peanut butter fudge.
Yeah, I've had peanut butter fudge. I just assumed that there was a little bit of chocolate in it.
Now, I can say I don't know what the hell fudge is, truly. I saw a girl make
fudge
it
just seems
sometime.
Congealed, like congealed something. Of the thing that you're eating.
I think there's condensed milk in it. I think it's, there's a thing. Mm-hmm. You can make fudge different. I've had peppermint fudge, all kinds of fudge. Because, you know, we've all been to a mountain town. And been to a, oh my God, I just had the word for it. General store. But yeah, I'm just saying that, like, no, there's not a lot. I don't know there's a lot of mainstream, out here every day, vanilla candies. No, that's not a thing. While chocolate is everywhere.
Maybe it's the demand and they have to up the supply.
What are you talking about, chocolate?
Yeah. I think that vanilla, maybe it's just not in demand like that. So then they get by how they can get by. You have to get it how you live, as they say.
So you're...
you know, in the streets.
And if anybody's in the streets, it's chocolate. Vanilla is a flavor. Chocolate is a thing, if that makes sense.
Nope. I will not let you do this.
As
this,
in.
This is like, how conspiracy theories start. This is no. Vanilla is a flavor. Chocolate is a thing. All right. And it's not a thing from this world. And it's an inside job. You can find the real chocolate, the original chocolate, at Area 52. That's the area they don't tell you about. Nah.
What I'm saying, for the same way that, like, in the same way that mint can't be a bar.
Mm-hmm.
Mint doesn't do what chocolate does. But you're not out here attacking mint.
Because other people have not had the audacity to compare mint and chocolate. They'll put the mint
flavors.
In chocolate.
See, that's what I'm saying. I'm comparing flavors. Mm-hmm. You are trying to compare carriers of the flavors. Bars, cakes, ice cream. So I'm talking about the flavor.
I'm with you. I'm just saying I'm proving that there's a better flavor by where it goes and what it can do and how many people want it in all its forms.
So you're saying that because it has a bigger distribution because of the nature of the plant because of what it can become.
I'll make a full plain flavor argument right now. Okay. Uh-huh. In a chocolate milkshake and a vanilla milkshake at a diner. A mistake that I often see it happen. I've had it happen to me throughout my entire life. When you get a vanilla milkshake,
yes,
the ratio of milk can be off, and it can easily be off because vanilla is a carrier. The distribution of milk and chocolate in a chocolate shake is much harder to mess up because if you put too much milk in a chocolate shake, it's not even going to look like a chocolate shake. It's going to look like a dirty milk, you know?
So you're saying just because vanilla and milk are both white?
No. I'm saying what I've had happen to me in my life has been milkshakes, whether they were chocolate or vanilla. The vanilla, sometimes it can't even overpower the milk. Now I'm just drinking some cold milk with some ice in it with a little bit of vanilla flavor.
So because you've been to a diner owned by some cheap motherfuckers who bought cheap ass ice cream or thought that somebody wouldn't notice because they didn't put enough vanilla ice cream in to this milkshake, this is vanilla's fault? Because I've had some very amazing vanilla milkshakes, but honestly, my milkshake of choice is strawberry or a cookies and cream or have you been to the Chick-fil-A and had
the peach?
The peach one.
Oh, the lemonade one,
the frosted lemonade.
Yeah,
or a mint cookies and cream shake.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the fact that you're not saying vanilla is a bit telling.
I've said vanilla and I also said other things that I like.
Mm-hmm.
Because One, I'm not always a milkshake person, okay?
Okay.
But you know what I love? I love a blizzard from Dairy Queen. But yeah, it's all I'm saying is that I'm not trying to win here.
Real quick, I'm so sorry. I'm just, because I also know we have to wrap up soon. You reminded me. You know how at Dairy Queen, they're supposed to flip the blizzard upside down to show you how thick it is? Fall out. And there's nothing like when it falls out. Because the cashier and the driver just looking at it on the ground. And then they got to go do another one. But it's like, make it, when you, the confidence that they flip it, and it almost never falls out. So then when it's a little too thin and they go,
well, that's why, you ever seen the British Baking Show? They're like, oh, your meringue is good if you can turn it over above your head and it doesn't fall out. And I'm like, why are we testing this that way?
It doesn't have to be the head. Yeah,
it doesn't have to be your head. It could go over your workbench. I would test it over a trash can. Like, why is it? Because you'll see him just like looking up at it like, I hope it doesn't fall out. What the fuck is wrong with you? You're on, you're international television. Do you, you must trust you a lot, or you trust these peaks to really be popping like this. I know that a lot of people are going to disagree with me, but that's because we all love a chocolate bar. You know, it wasn't, you know, Charlie and the Vanilla Factory. That didn't happen. So I understand that people have a place in their hearts for chocolate. I didn't expect to win this. Okay? I just wanted to have the discussion. So listen, I'm Dulcé Sloan, okay, on the things, D-U-L-C-E-S-L-O-A-N, on all of the social media platforms that make you question your self-esteem. And this is my friend, my cohort, my buddy,
Josh Johnson. And you can find me on all the stuff at Josh Johnson Comedy. TikTok, YouTube, all that stuff. Hit me up on Instagram. Let us know in the comments of these videos that get posted what you think. And feel free to let us know what you'd love to hear us talk about next. If there's a classic duo that you think one's better than the other, if there's a classic rivalry that you want to get our thoughts on, y'all just let us know. But we appreciate you listening. We hope you had fun listening. And I hope you have a great day into the weekend.
Call your mom.